every captivity we went through, including America, times 100, man.
Yep.
Man, it's gonna be so bad out here. When all hell breaks loose, he gonna be running for his life. He gonna be running for exercise. He gonna be putting them monsters to work for real, man, to keep people off his ass. You know, it's gonna get bad out here, man. You ain't gonna be out here jogging for leisure when all hell breaks loose. You're gonna be running for your life. Go ahead.
Hey, let me, that's a piggyback on what you read and asked, man. Because Peter, Paul had knew about them, about when they was gonna get, when Jerusalem was gonna get sacked, man, and they was gonna have to flee. This is a letter he wrote to them. This is 2 Thessalonians 1 and 4. He says, so that we ourselves glory in you and the church of the power for your patience and faith in all your persecutions and tribulations. Because they was going through persecutions and tribulations too, man. And Paul gave them, hey, we're gonna pray for you, man. Because that's why us brothers, we need to be praying for other brothers, man. Because when this thing hit, man, it's not gonna be like a great roundup and everybody gets caught at the same time. You gonna have brothers, man, some brothers, scripture says some brothers gonna go to concentration camp. Some brothers are gonna be in, some brothers are gonna be out in the wilderness. Some brothers gonna be saved. Some brothers gonna be safe in a place, you know, eating. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be different levels, man. You know, everybody's not gonna be out here running, man. You know, but if whatever position that Yahushua got you in, man.
Right, that's why the scripture says he won't put more on you than you can
that's
bear.
That's right, brother. Because
certain brothers can take more than certain brothers.
Right. And me myself, like I told every head on camp, man, the brother Dimash, man. Hey, for some reason, man, the Lord be putting the spirit on me, man. I know, learn about certain plants and, you know, I love knives, you know what I'm saying? I want to do the I might be one of the good ones out there, man. You know, I mean, whatever the spirit, hey, man, the Lord's going, hey, man, he's going to put that spirit on you, man. And if you got the word in you, you're going to know what to do, man. I love to use that analogy about Neo, man. When agents was coming to get him and he was telling him which way to go. You know, but hey, Neo didn't listen, man. When he told him to get on that scaffold, when he came out the office, he said, get on. He was like, no way. He looked down at the field, he said, no way. Hey, it's faith. And he got captured. And he got chipped up.
Matthew 24:22. And except those days be shortened, there should no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened.
See, that's why time has sped up. Because hell, we already finna be in the year 2017, man.
Right.
I want the Lord to speed these times and speed these days up for the elect's sake. Because why? You know, Esau is trying to take us out. Now, if the Lord would stretch a week out, like it used to be when we were growing up, how it seemed like it took forever for a week to end, there'd be no more Israelites left, man. Esau is totally trying to wipe us all out, man. But that's why the Lord's speeding up these days, and also he's speeding up these days to speed his return, man. For his return to come back sooner and quicker, man. So we won't have to wait another 20 or 30 years for his return, man. See, the time we're going through is just like seconds to the Lord, man.
Right.
Yeah. See what I'm saying? Right. Just like seconds to the Lord, man. You know, go ahead.
It says, then if any man shall say unto you, lo, here is Christ, or there, believe it not. For there shall be a rise of false Christ and false prophets, and show great signs and wonders, and so much that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect.
It said, if it was possible, because if the Lord is dealing with you, you're going to be fooled by Esau's tricks, man. And Esau's going to come to a program called Project Bluebeam,
right,
that he's going to use to try and deceive the very elect to believe that's the Lord coming back.
Right, buddy.
But you're going to know it's not the Lord, because the Lord told you, I shall not meet thee as a man.
That's right.
So when he come back, he's going to come back in his angelic force.
That's right.
See what I'm saying?
Knowing the scriptures, man, because you've been told by these wicked ass churches, man, that the Lord is gonna split the sky. If that's all you know, guess what? You're gonna believe that, man. that's what you gonna believe. But that's, the scriptures don't read, don't say that, man. Okay? Now I gotta keep it. Just read today, 1,000 years. This is 2 Peter 3:8. He said, but beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day.
What
you had just said about the time, man. This is seconds to the Lord, man. You know, to us it seems long, man. You know, the Lord, our time is not. You always heard that in church. Our time, and Lord, he's right on time. You know, he is right on time, man. You know what I'm saying? He's not on you. Okay, because you see all these things happen. The Lord says he's gonna come as a thief in the night, man. Right. A thief is not preparing to get his house broken into. He's probably scoping out your house, man, knowing when your ass go to work. You know, so when you going out somewhere, man, that's when he's gonna come. A thief in the night, that means you're not gonna be, it's gonna be unbeknownst to you, man. Right. You're not gonna be prepared for that.
Right.
You know, and then these people ride by and big up us, man, that's not gonna save you, man. You can't piggyback off another man's salvation. All right, you should be pulling over, man, and trying to see. And basically, we have a time now, people know what we're doing, man. You know, back home, man, and Garrett, people stop in and actually just donate now. So they, because they either they've seen this thing on the internet, like your brother mentioned earlier, or either they know, they just know, man. We got pictures up, man, of the faces, separate folks here. People know we out here preaching, man. And when you see Israelites, man, Israelites is in the scriptures. So if you know about the scriptures, you relate that, man, you know we out here preaching. So you're gonna have no excuse. What scripture says? Thou art inexcusable, old man, whoever thou art. You're gonna be inexcusable to say, oh well, look, that my prophets was out there on the streets. You was shopping and you walked past the street. You was jogging and you rolled right past it. So you're gonna have no excuse in that day, man. So when your ass gets shackled up, man, don't call on your door then, man.
Say, behold, I have told you before. Wherefore, if they shall say unto you, behold, he is in the desert, go not forth. Behold, he is in the secret chambers, believe it not. For as the lightning cometh out of the east and shining even unto the west, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For wheresoever the carcass is, there will the eagles be gathered together.
Right.
Immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from the heaven, and the power of heaven shall be shaken.